Hello friends, through this video I will give beginner investors an idea as to how to look at the insurance industry. Technically, 2017 was the birth of insurance in the listed space, with three back-to-back IPOs hitting the street. It is one of the niche sectors to look at, with a penetration of 2.7% compared to the global average of 3.3%. Hence, this space is highly underpenetrated and there is a lot of potential for growth. Insurance is divided into two broad types, life insurance and general insurance. Life insurance continues to be a key component of household financial savings, and from FY15, the contribution of these life insurance premiums was increased by 3 to 5 percentage points. Their product mix comprises of individual savings, group savings, individual protection, and group protection. Individual savings are further subdivided into PAR, non-PAR, and ULIPs product categories. All these together make up the new business premium for a life insurance company. Whereas non-life insurance covers diverse lines of business relating to protection of assets such as vehicles, which has motor, third party and motor own damage types, property, marine, crop, fire, healthcare and various business and individual liabilities. The evolving mix from agency to multi-channel distribution network has enabled the industry to reach various participants on convenience and ease. Moving on to what an investor should look at before picking up an insurance company. There are not many listed players in the insurance space, and in challenging times, it is better to stick to the leaders which have the highest solvency ratios, strong banker partners, a wide distribution network, and a diverse product mix. The profit and loss statement of an insurance company is extremely different than any other industry. So the first parameter to look at is premium growth. Life insurance companies report annual premium equivalent, also known as APE, which forms the top line in life insurance players. It simply means the premiums received by the companies from its various products. It measures the volume of new business premiums written in the course of the year. An investor should look for consistent improvement in APE growth. General insurance players, on the other hand, call this gross written premium, also known as GWP. Now, if we compare APE CAGR of life insurance players from FY17 to FY20, you will see that HDFC Life has shown the highest CAGR at 21%, while others are lower. Among the listed general insurance players in the past year, GIC RE has aced with a YOY growth of 12%. Moving on to the NBP and NBM. New business premium is the premium attained by new policies sold in the year, and it should continuously grow for a company. A 20% or higher NBP growth is a good benchmark standard to start with, and both ICICI Pru and SBI Life have delivered the same. Moreover, new business margins are an important factor for an investor to look at, since they show the profitability of a business. A higher percentage, which is rising YOY and Q-on-Q, is better. Moving on to value of new business and VNB margins. VNB is the present value of future profits that is associated with new businesses. This parameter helps to gauge if the operational efficiency and scale are enabling the value of the business to improve. HDFC Life has the highest VNB margins among life insurers at 25.9% YOY, while ICICI Pru and Max Life are both competing for the second place at around 21%. The next one is embedded value, which is a valuation measure to estimate the consolidated value of shareholders' interest in the insurance company. A price to EV and price to VNB are used as common valuation multiples, and India's current average is 3.5 times price to EV and 42.9 times its price to VNB. From our model portfolio, HDFC Life is currently trading at price to EV higher than the industry's average at 5x, while SBI Life is undervalued at 3x. But HDFC Life's multiple justifies the growth it has been delivering, and hence we have added it to our portfolio. An investor should check for higher VNB margins as they translate to higher EV in the longer term. Next, moving on to another important factor an investor must check in insurance companies is persistency ratio. It helps to measure how long customers stick with the policies. Policy retention and policy renewals both contribute to this factor. The most common persistency ratios are measured for 13th month, which is the first year retention, 25th month for 2 years, 37th, 49th, and 61st month. Persistency ratios have been the lowest in India compared to the globe, and efforts should be made by companies to improve this ratio. Higher rates of persistency translate into increased profitability, reduced costs, overall growth with optimal long-term income. Higher persistency ratios in the non-par and protection businesses of a company can lead to increase in new business share, thus improving margins. HDFC Life's higher share in the protection business is prominently visible through the margin expansion and higher 13-month persistency ratio. Moving on to claims ratio. It is also something an investor should check. It is the compensation asked for by the insurance holder for a covered loss or policy event. A lower claims ratio is beneficial for an insurance company. SBI Life has the lowest claims ratio in the life genre, while ICICI Lombard is the winner in the general insurance space. Combined ratio is also an important measure to gauge whether a business is profitable or loss-making. It is the addition of claims ratio and OPEX ratio. A combined ratio below 100% indicates that the company is making underwriting profit. The profitability scorecard of a general insurance business is measured by the company's ability to generate underwriting profits. Now, in an insurance business, an investor must always look out for a higher proportion of product mix which is long-tailed in nature. As a long-tailed business carries a longer settlement period, which gives access to the investment float for a longer period of time. This will in turn lead to higher ROEs, and this higher investment leverage will result in better returns. For example, motor, third party, and engineering or liability insurance are all long-tailed in nature. General insurance companies with a higher proportion to any of the above is expected to generate better returns. In addition to the above, an investor should also check the solvency ratio, PAT growth, ROE, commission ratio, and a few other parameters. There are a number of other triggers for the insurance sector to grow going ahead. For life insurance players, firstly, price hikes will benefit as these players can pass on the reinsurance rate hikes. Second, is shifting to online channels to steer growth amidst social distancing. Third, is strong demand from protection segment in the future, which in the past 3 years portrayed strong demand of about 45 to 50%. A faster recovery from non-banca channels due to their lower dependence on ULIPs and growth in insurance premiums are also very big triggers. Historically, post-SARS impacted China, MERS hit Saudi Arabia, life premiums surged around 20 to 52% in the second year after the breakout. This time too, it is expected that life insurers will witness a surge in demand once things settle down. While for general insurance companies, larger renewal rates will lead to higher GWP and tie-ups with OEM dealers will increase bargaining power and in turn sales. With the mandatory long-term TP insurance going live, the role of the OEM dealer network has become very important. Introduction of long-term third-party policy was a positive development in terms of increasing persistency, which will help in reducing loss ratios and growing the investment float income. And this in turn should be ROE accretive. A higher investment float will in the end translate to operating profits. However, there are several challenges for life insurers, such as if the persistency ratio softens as people focus on conserving cash and more individuals move towards the next new tax slabs. While life insurers can now sell health plans, which will increase competition for Sahi and health insurance players. Any new government regulation not in favor of insurance companies can also significantly affect their future growth. The future of life insurance and general insurance is extremely bright as the players have gained significant amount of experience from the various regulatory changes over the course of years. They have built a strong foundation now, and the underpenetrated nature with digital presence will give them a firm footing going ahead. Right from Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana to Ayushman Bharat Yojana, these comprehensive schemes are playing a big role in covering a wider population under the insurance bucket. COVID-19 has brought about a small dent in the new business insurance premiums, especially to the ULIPs category. However, once demand normalizes and equities show a rosier trajectory, insurance will regain importance. Thank you. We hope this video helps you in picking the right insurance company for your portfolio.